I mean, there's been a little bit of coverage about her. Some people don't know she has a cousin.
One word.
Oh, okay, I missed that, sorry.
That's okay, that's all right. Welcome to News Beast. We have great Kelly Goff in the house and Howie Kurtz. Howie, you've got a piece up today on the Ryan honeymoon that I think is going to be proven very prescient in 2, 3, 1. The backlash is coming.
What the countdown. But I have to say, in the first 72 hours, the so-called liberal media told us all about Paul Ryan. He goes hunting. He makes his own Polish sausages. He's a fitness buff. He's hot, according to Politico. and treated him as a pretty cool guy.
Yeah.
But I predicted, and I think it's even starting to happen this morning, that there'd be a second wave of stories about his budget-cutting record in Congress, where he gets his money from, that would paint a somewhat darker picture than those initial stories.
Yeah, and I think this wasn't just sort of token, let's be fair to the nominee, which is important to do, but I think genuine affection for him as a person known on Capitol Hill. But there is the other side, which is it's not just how friendly you are, it's how you voted. And that is a totally legitimate second look, don't you think, Guy?
Absolutely. I mean, I agree with him in terms of the first round of coverage, right? Unlike Sarah Palin, he wasn't entirely unknown to a lot of the D.C. Press corps. And generally speaking, what you hear is that people say, look, he's a nice guy, he's got a nice family, he's very courteous, even if you completely disagree with him on issues. But that being said, at a certain point, you also have to look at the policies, right?
Well, why was Paul Ryan picked? He was picked because he is an intellectual leader of the Republican Party and has put out a blueprint that the House actually passed, which would remake Medicare into a voucher program, which would make deep cuts in domestic programs, which would continue tax cuts and actually lower capital gains. So, of course, this is going to be fair game. The Romney people knew that they were buying this when they picked Paul Ryan, and journalists would be derelict in their duty if they didn't delve into this quite deeply.
Something else that I think is interesting, too, about the coverage is I think that the Catholic media, if you will, if you can call them that, some of the press that actually covers Catholicism or is focused on that has been interesting already, right? Because I've seen a couple of pieces about the issue of poverty and about the concerns among some Catholic leaders in terms of his attempt to cut programs for the poor. I actually think this could be a year where they actually make more of a difference.
But John, as much respect as Paul Ryan gets from Beltway and New York press corps, he's courted the pundits over the years, do you think half the country knows who he is?
No, and I think that's what the polls that have come out showing he's, somewhere in quail land when it comes to approval really reflect the fact that he's unknown. I mean, I think if we're going to be completely fair. And of course, he's never even run statewide, which is one reason this is a really risky pick. One note your story had in it is the fact that Romney's advisors weren't thrilled about the Ryan pick at first. It seems to be the candidate who was pushing for it. Everyone else knew the risks.
It's a gamble. The safe pick would have been, Tim Pawlenty or Rob Portman.
So
clearly it has energized not just the conservative base, although I don't know where else they had to go, but, Rupert Murdoch, Rush Limbaugh, the Wall Street Journal editorial page, the Weekly Standard, they're all excited about Paul Ryan, but they're not necessarily independent voters in swing states who have to be convinced that Ryan is not going to take away health care for senior citizens.
That's right.
Well, look, he doesn't definitely deliver a swing state. He doesn't definitely deliver a particular demographic that was looking to go elsewhere. The only thing he really possibly delivers for Governor Romney is a measure of authenticity and as a conservative, right? Because that's something that he certainly wasn't going to get if he didn't have someone who was kind of seen as a symbol of the standard. I think
authenticity, period. And I do think the campaign's making a conscious effort for the Catholic vote, which is why your comment will be so fascinating to see how that cleaves out. On the electoral map, I just don't see how Florida just got a lot harder to win. And if Florida's harder to win, the Romney's team mission is much harder to achieve.
Well, on the other hand, Ryan is an articulate spokesman for conservative economics. And maybe, just maybe, I'm not making predictions here, he will push the coverage of this election into a more substantive direction.
I hope he does.
Etch-a-sketch. It's interesting, not everybody agrees with my assessment. I asked for Twitter questions for Beast TV and got one from Ivy McClellan, who said, judging from what I've seen so far, Ryan is getting the same treatment Sarah Palin got. No respect. Do you think it will continue? No respect.
I don't remember that.
Yeah, I don't think I've been paying attention to what the coverage has actually been.
Palin initially got a great wave of positive
coverage.
Exactly. She came out even before the convention speech and was a fresh face. This is before we found out what she didn't know.
Well, it has fired, but and Axelrod made this comment yesterday comparing the two, which I thought was inappropriate. But in terms of enthusiasm of the base, the big crowds, sure, there's a comparison. But Paul Ryan is the anti-Palin to the extent that he really is a policy wonk. And it's just a different profile of a person, fundamentally.
Well, one thing you can't say about him is that he's not substantive.
He really
is. Disagree with him, but that you can't say that he lacks experience.
Or that he lacks experience. He's been in Congress a long time. He worked for Jack Kemp before that.
Sure.
And so,
a known policy wonk, too.
Right. You may not agree with his policies, and I think probably half the country doesn't and half the country does, but he knows his stuff.
And also, you also have to give him points for being authentic, right? I mean,
sure.
The reason that Santorum had a following is because you knew he actually believed what he said. And there are a lot of people who disagree with Ryan who know that he believes what he says, too.
Absolutely. No one doubts his sincerity.
Not a lot of people feel that way about Governor Mitt Romney.
Well, that's one balancing aspect. You've got two great columns up. One I really enjoyed, which compared sort of Olympic athletes to our political folks on the field.
They're political doppelgangers.
Yes, which I enjoy. But you also had a column on Ryan and race. And some of the comments we've been getting on Facebook are about that.
Okay.
One has a very specific question that I look forward to hearing your answer to, which is, what are Ryan and Romney's plans for addressing violence that's beset urban communities, from Brenda Jones? This is really a question for the Republican Party.
Well, I actually think it's a question for both parties, but I will go ahead and dive in. I mean, Ryan has made it very clear that he has, well, let me just stop here and say, he's got a great rating from the NRA. So that tells us a lot where he stands on issues like gun control. And while I'm incredibly sympathetic and don't want to minimize at all what happened in Colorado, I always try to remind people that gun deaths are the leading cause of deaths of young black men, and it rarely gets the level of coverage it does when it kind of seeps out and touches other communities. And I think both parties have shown a lack of serious engagement on the issue of gun control. You know, you can make the argument that Romney and Ryan's plan is a little bit worse, but I haven't really heard President Obama saying a lot on that issue either.
Even after Aurora, Colorado.
Absolutely.
That's right.
And the latest shooting in the Sikh temple. Gun control seems to, politically at least, remain off the table.
Yeah, even though Mayors Against Illegal Guns have really shown there are places of common ground here, and of course President Obama, actually like Governor Romney, supported an assault weapons ban in the past, reinstating it. Final word, Howie.
Janesville, Wisconsin, as in Paul Ryan's hometown.
I like it, Janesville.
Well, I think that I'm really interested to see some of the coverage that his missus is going to continue to get. I mean, there's been a little bit of coverage about her. Some people don't know she has a cousin.
One word.
Oh, okay, missed that. Sorry.
That's okay. That's all right. It's your first time at News Beast.
Bye.
It's a little thing.
That's my word.
That always works.
I'll do Polish sausage hyphenated. That's all for us at News Beast today. We'll see you tomorrow.